microdose, yeah. Microdose,
microdose, microdose, dose, dose. Microdose, microdose, dose, dose. Microdose, microdose, dose, dose.
What's good, y'all? Kush Hayes here. Happy New Year, everybody. I get to say that one more time next week, too. Happy New Year, y'all. Hope you had a fantastic Christmas. I hope you had a fantastic set of holidays. And, you know, just going to get right into it. Friend of the family, you know him from the Waffle Box podcast, the original Waffle Box. You accept no substitutes because it is the best part of Wednesday. Coming to you all the way from Super Bowl 60. It's the People's Podcast. And you love us because we do this. We do this because we love you, Mike Fish. Welcome back to the Microdose. Happy New Year, sir.
Hello. How's it going, buddy?
It's good, man. It's good. You know, I hate to be that guy, but yeah, I can't believe it's already the end of the year. And it was just April the other day, man. Like, where does the time go? Honestly, it's I hate to be that cliche, but where the fuck? What happened? How did this? How are we at the end of 2023 already?
I don't know, but it's definitely full gear into that season of what the fuck day is this?
Yeah, right.
I don't even know. I was thinking about this the other day. Like, is Christmas like the morning after losing your virginity, where you wake up with a hangover and be like, wait, was that it? Maybe, I don't know. Because there was so much hype around Christmas. It always is. But yeah, the next day I'm like, oh, well, now I just have to tidy up and I'm hungover.
Yeah, I wasn't hungover when I lost my virginity, but yes, I relate with the that's it. Huh. Thought there would have been a little bit more to it, you know. I also just wasn't in the spirit this year. And
I know what you mean. It was a shitty Christmas this year.
Was it? I'm sorry to hear that. Like, I didn't think it was a shitty Christmas, but the closer to it, and like I got everything for everybody. Like I cleared many objectives this year getting to Christmas, but once we got there, it's like, all right, it's Monday.
Yeah, if anyone's listening to this that spent time with me over Christmas, I don't want to sound like I'm insulting you. I had lots of fun over Christmas, but it was definitely a, it's Christmas tomorrow? Oh, okay. Like, it just didn't feel like, you know what I mean? I don't think I even saw the Coca-Cola commercial once this year. It was, what the hell?
Oh, wow. And they love bringing out that polar bear too. It's crazy.
The polar bear.
What'd you do for Christmas?
The most famous polar bear ever. No, Vegas was Thanksgiving, so I just stayed home. So Christmas Eve, I was DD, which is always fun. So
DD,
shout out to Heineken Zero.
Yeah, designated driver. Nice, good.
But you know, Christmas parties when you're sober, they don't fun. Especially when everyone else is drunk and it's like, oh, can I just go home now? But yeah, so my Christmas Eve was spent watching everyone else have fun, and then I got drunk people in my car and I drove them home, and then once I finally got home, I stuck on a Godzilla movie and drank rum and coke.
Nice.
And then the next thing I realized, oh, it's 4 a.m. I should probably go to bed.
Also nice. But yeah, half sounds way better than the first half. Where you so much to fun. Enjoy some rum and cokes.
I can't remember which Godzilla movie it is, but it's, you'll know definitely. But it's the one with that really annoying young lady from Stranger Things. She was in it.
She's in two of those movies. I'm guessing it wasn't Godzilla vs. Kong.
It was not. Kong was so not King in of the this Monsters, one.
Then. Yeah,
King of the Monsters. Yeah.
Yeah. Beautiful movie, terrible story, terrible everything, terrible acting, terrible plot. Like, it was just again, great looking movie. Everything else was dog shit though. Like,
the monsters look fantastic.
I'd give 10 out of 5 on the monsters.
Yeah.
10 out of 5 on the monsters, 0 out of 5 on everything else. Like, I remember just sitting there, like, we watched it on the IMAX and I was just like, I've never been so bored by something so beautiful. Like, it's fucking stupid.
I would say, making this point, and maybe you can argue whether I'm correct or wrong, is, but I would argue, there is no bad Godzilla movie.
Hmm. Debatable.
But in that, they're all good in some aspects, if that makes sense. You know what I mean?
Well, are we talking about some, this newest batch of American Godzillas?
Or what? So I guess after King of the Monsters, mm-hmm. is there any more?
Yeah. We had Kong versus Godzilla, or Godzilla versus Godzilla.
Is that after this one? How did I miss this one? Because I saw Godzilla versus Kong. How did I miss this one? What the hell? But no, yeah, okay, yeah, I have my own thing with Godzilla versus Kong. The ending wasn't very good. It was it was very Freddy versus Jason esque.
Yeah, yeah.
If you ask me,
that was the point. And so this April we are getting Godzilla X Kong, colon subtitle something or other. But Godzilla and Kong got to team up and fight a whole race of Kongs that are living underground.
Oh, so X. Okay, I thought you said Godzilla X Con, and I thought it was going to be like Godzilla who just got out of jail and he's trying to be happy.
He's a little ankle monitor.
Yeah, I gotta get a job. No, I gotta keep clean.
No using your fire breath for 3 years, Godzilla.
I'm banned from Tokyo for 3 years. I gotta keep clean. That'd be a good movie. I'd watch that.
Whoever's out there that has artistic integrity and skills of an artist, make that little short right now. Godzilla X-Con.
X-Con.
That is funny. I had a Christmas party of my own, Christmas Eve. Not here. We were invited to a soiree. Nice little friends of the family, extended family gimmick. That was a lot of fun. Until I had to leave. I mean, by the time I left, majority of everyone left because we're like, well, we did the white elephant gimmick. We all ate a lot. We've been drinking and got to put the kids to bed. However, I had to go to church on Christmas Eve. We do it every year. My mom's in the choir, Mama Hayes. And, you know, for the longest time, it was the only thing she ever asked of me. You know, she's a little older. She has to ask for more. But, you know, it's the 1 hour of my life that I would just be like, all right, we're doing church on Christmas Eve. No problem. I'd rather be getting a root canal, but okay, let's do this.
Did you start feeling the sizzle when you entered the church? Did you start burning alive?
No. I'm exempt from all that. So, or at least in that church I am. But yeah, you know, she knows church has never been my thing. And for us to just drop something, especially on Christmas Eve where we're having fun, so we can go to church at 8 o'clock at night, I don't know what she was expecting for me to say when she's like, so what did you think of the service? I was just like, I'm not trying to be rude. Again, this is her fucking biggest thing. But it was church on Christmas Eve, Ma. I'm sorry. I don't know what else to tell you. I wish I could give you some constructive criticism. I know that's what you're looking for. No, I just don't have it. I'm sorry. You know, you sung in church.
Yeah, when it comes to that, I'm not going to knock anyone for their religious beliefs and their religious followings and things like that. But mm-hmm. I just, for someone that grew up Roman Catholic and then got out of that shit, I just can't. If you enjoy doing that thing, that's fine. But I just can't see anyone's walking out of church after a mass and being like, "Boom! He fucking nailed that! Hit that out the park!" It's mass. It's Sunday service. It's. Mm-hmm. The same thing every week.
Yeah. And, you know, but the bitch of it is, like, if I was super into it, the church was super dark, which, you know, is a nice ambiance thing. I'll give them that much. But then, like, I can't read the program at all. Like, I'm at that age, was like, fuck, I left my reading glasses at home. Even if I wanted to follow along with this, I can't.
Who was the choreographer again? I can't see this. This should win an Oscar.
You know, it's at least good to know, like, all right, we're here on page 3 and there's only 4 more pages left. Okay.
Yeah, that's the only reason for the church manual, whatever it is that you just keep checking it. It's like, geez, okay, how far are we into this are we? Okay, so we've been here about 40 minutes. So on my estimates, we've got about 25 minutes left. Okay, I can work. I can deal with this. I can deal with this. That's what I do for every wedding I go to at church. I'm like, oh, fuck's sake. We're only on page 2. Fuck. Yeah.
I somehow don't have a problem with church weddings, but you know, anything else, I'm just like, ah,
Oh,
rather
right.
bash
Real
my head
quick,
against the wall
right?
right now.
I did this one thing where it was, I'm not going to mention any names in case they're listening to them. I don't want to put them on blast, but I mean, I guess once I tell a story, they'll know it's about them. But so I went to a wedding and it was like a group wedding. And it was like them and like six other couples all getting married at the same time. And because of the area that we are in, nothing against this, but because of the area that we're in, they had to do the service in English and in Spanish. So at every point, they would say something in English and then they would repeat it in Spanish. So the whole wedding took literally twice as long as it normally would. Oh my God, I wanted to kill
And with
myself.
six other people or six other couples.
Well, luckily that bit was pretty quick because he was like, "Hey, do you? Yep. Do you? Yep. Do you? Yep." So that bit went pretty quickly. He just felt the need to be like, you know, so what is the definition of love? Let's talk about this. So in 1464, this person's just get on with it.
Jesus Christ.
Shit. Indeed. I think
No.
he's to blame.
Yeah.
But anyway, happy birthday, Jeezy. Jeezy Creezy. Happy
Happy
birthday.
birthday, Jay-Z.
Belated birthday.
On Christmas Day, we had to drive 3 hours to Sonora, California, not to be confused with Sonoma, California, but Sonora is like up in the mountains, like it's a 3 hour drive. And thankfully, no one was on the road Christmas, so we flew up that fucking hill. But we also did it in an electric vehicle for the first time. And I was like, oh no. Yeah, not a fan of the electric vehicle, dude. We drove a Kia Niro. And then I was like, all right, so the battery holds about 250 miles or so of dashboards, and it's 150. So we'll have enough energy to spare. And I just got to worry about finding a charge station. We get there with 50 miles to spare for some reason. And then my uncle's like, yeah, there's a whole bank of chargers by this hospital. Follow me and we'll get you plugged in. And then, you know, after dinner or whatever, we'll come back and it is what it is. Plug this sucker in. And, you know, we had 20% left on the battery. And then it was like, it will take 10 and a half hours for this to fully recharge.
Oof.
And I was like, get the fuck out of here. Best part is, thankfully, it was free. It did not cost us X number of pennies per kilowatt,
Well, it cost
which
you
is
10.5 hours.
10 and a half hours, though. Yeah. And we didn't even do all 10 and a half hours. I think we did about 7.5 hours, maybe 8 hours. And then I was like, good luck to us getting home. But by the way, we were fine. And for some reason, again, we didn't have a 100% battery on the way home, but somehow had 70 miles to spare. And then I called the people at Hertz and I was like, hey, what's the penalty if I don't return this thing refueled? And they're like, $35. And I was like, you know what? That's way better than
Take that
parking this
money.
thing in San Francisco for 10 and a half hours, not in front of my house, and then worried about the windows breaking or the catalytic converter being stolen. Or et cetera, et cetera. So, bit the $35 and turned that sucker in the other day. And I don't like. I felt like I was being tethered. Like I wish the rental company had like, if not a hybrid, just a regular car, because you know, you go to a gas station, what 10 minutes tops, just to fill the tank. Like
That's all good if they are.
yeah, so. Anyway, man. So we got 2024. We're literally right around the corner. You excited about anything coming up? You got any big trips you're taking? The waffle box. You gonna be doing anything different with the waffle box?
As for 2024 as a whole, no, I've got to that point where I'm sure something fun will happen, but I've gone beyond that point of like, you know what? This will be my year. This is when everything's gonna turn around. No, it's gonna be. I'm sure at this point next year I'll be like, oh, that went quick. Ooh, maybe 2025 will be my year. So yeah, I'll just see what happens. But as for Waffle Box, you know, trying to do some fun things. Very proud, looking back, I guess. 52 weeks, 52 episodes, me and you, boom, nailed it.
In multiple countries.
Multiple countries. So yeah, we're gonna try to do the live aspect again with the 138 episode spectacular coming up at the end of February. But yeah, I think we're just trying to fine tune that bad boy and see where we go with that. Because I think, you know, as much fun as it is, I still think there's room for improvement. There's always room for improvement for everything you do, I guess. I don't think we've got the finished product quite yet, but I think it's a fun thing to jump into. If you haven't listened to it, definitely check it out. Go to enjoyboxbox.com.
There you go. So, yeah, I myself, not really looking forward to anything on the spectrum. I'm not even sure I want to do Amsterdam again this year.
yeah. No redhead days?
Yeah, I don't know, man. I mean, I've been there like 6 times now. I like hooking up with my friends out there.
Yes, what's up?
Maybe I'm just getting too old now. Like this year took it out of me. Like I was just kind of like, oh wow. Or maybe I spent too much time there. I don't know what it was, but yeah, coming home I was like, maybe we want to try something different next year. I don't know. And it's all to be determined, TBD. But yeah, and you know, as maybe far as Waffle Box goes,
maybe go to a blonde hair festival.
Ooh, in Germany, I hear those are popular.
I mean, because you're bald, they won't be able to tell. And then if they try to say anything, there's just yell, well, discrimination, think, at the top of your voice, and they'll let you in.
I'm pretty sure the facial hair.
And the beard, the ginger beard. Is
it's going to give it away. Yeah. So,
I'll bleach it.
Yeah, you bleach it.
I will. You come here, I'll bleach your beard.
Oh, no. That's going to be turn into some sort of weird fan fiction there. Yikes.
Also, I have no idea what I'm doing, so I'm sure it will hurt. So no, I apologize.
Yeah, it burns! It's burning. My beautiful face. My beautiful face. Why, Mike? Why? And then, as far as the Waffle Box, yeah, I was... you and I did our New Year's Eve special. We recorded it a little while ago, I guess. And I was going through old reviews so I could talk about the top 3, top 5 movies that I saw this year. And I was looking back at old reviews and I was like, fuck, my camera footage looks terrible. Like, you know, when we're doing this live, I have no idea what it looks like. And the finished product is what you stir and pour together, Mike Fish. So, but I'm just like, ah, man, that's all on my end. We need to do something about that as soon as we can. So I hope to have that resolved. I hope to not come in choppy and or do 40 minutes reviews on insignificant films like The Marvels. Again, I like The Marvels, but, no way that review needed to be half the length of the movie. I'd like to course correct for things like that.
So. But that's what the one thing I do like about Waffle Box is that it's its own little animal there. Like we can have, because there'll be episodes where I'm like, oh Jesus Christ, this is going to be a drag. I've got really nothing to go on this week, and yet we end up going like 2 hours and 20 minutes of recording. Yeah. And then there'll be other episodes where I'm like, oh my God, this episode's going to be great. I've got so much great content. I can't wait to talk about this. And then it's like 1 hour and 10. Yeah. So it is what it is. And so if you know, I don't know, if the movie review goes that long, the best one though is still the Barbie review is where I think the Barbie review went almost an hour, but 45 minutes of it was you talking about your story about the Barbie movie, which was great stuff. If you haven't checked that out, go to the Waffle Box YouTube page and just search out Barbie review. I think it was the Barbie review.
No, I think you're talking about the Taylor Swift review.
The Taylor Swift, that's it. Sorry, yeah. My apologies. Yes, go to Taylor Swift Eras Tour review on the Waffle Box YouTube channel. It's great content.
And what that was I had told one dude like, hey, the Taylor Swift movies, it's all right. It's pretty good. I think you'd like it. And like I went,
and then he hated you after that.
Oh, well, so much toxicity. And that was the point of that. But yeah, that went on. I think that bit of the review is like 30 minutes long by itself. Like just it was an unusual movie. So an unusual movie review.
Unusual friend.
I feel like I told you on the Waffle Box, but I'll tell it for the folks on the Microdose. Yeah, like I sent little sister Hayes screenshots of that conversation, and she calls it like it is. So at first she's like, now Kush, I think you might be a little judgmental here. But then she's like, oh no, was this man drunk or high? And I was like, man, it's like 10:30 in the morning, so I hope not, but maybe. And he's like, this man is not well mentally. You need to stop interacting with him post haste. And I was like, I will take your advice on that. No problem.
Post haste. I need to use that more in my vernacular.
You do. It's a great phrase. Post haste. Get on.
Proceed. Post haste.
Proceed. Yeah. That's my favorite non-catchphrase of 2023 on the Waffle Box. Proceed.
I'll work it some way. Yeah. We'll get a t-shirt there.
There you go. There you go. Anything else on your horizon?
On my horizon this year going ahead, I'm just looking to obviously, you know, when it comes to listenership, because podcasting is essentially my, I'm very stereotypical British man. I work and I drink. That's my life. That's how I roll. So in terms of any kind of interestingness going out, you know, the podcasting thing is my big thing. I love that. It's my passion. I really, really do enjoy that. So I think in terms of listenership, I'm not too fussed about that. Okay. Because I think, you know, hey, I'm still old fashioned. I'm a hippy dippy kind of guy. Hey, if one person listens to it, then whatever. Because at the end of the day, I just enjoy recording it with my buddy Kush. We have fun every Wednesday when we record it on Mondays, but whatever. It's best part of Wednesdays. It's fun too. So as long as one person listens to it, I feel, hey, it was worth it kind of thing. I think what I would love to do is try to get more interaction, I guess, in terms of rather than, I'm not worried. So again, so worried about building up the listener base. That would be great if it happens, but you know, just trying to become a more interactive show. That'd be more, I think that'd be a lot of fun. So that's my aim for 2024.
Nice interactive waffle box. Yeah, I think that's exactly what the doctor ordered. I'm going to wrap this up in just a little bit, but when you're not doing the Waffle Box and when you're not guesting on the Microdose, you also do a show called Claret and Big Blue. It's about football. And, we're going to have you back for sure for the big game special, but...
big game.
Who do you think we're going to see in Big Game 58 this year?
Not the Giants. That's for goddamn sure. I mean, even though they're not doing as well as they have been last year, it's kind of rough to bet against old Patty Mahomes and the Swifties to make it to the Super Bowl. And then in terms of the NFC, I am really hoping for the 49ers, because if it's not the 49ers, then it's probably going to be Cowboys or the Eagles, and that will just be miserable, because then I'm going to be in a situation where I was like last year where I can't enjoy the game. All I'm just hoping, sitting there, is I fucking hope the Eagles lose. Please lose the Eagles. I hope the fucking Eagles lose. So yeah, my ideal would be Kansas City versus the San Francisco 49ers. That would be my perfect outcome for the Super Bowl this year, but I do fear in my loins that a Cowboys or an Eagles are going to sneak in again, which may be a sad panda.
Oh, don't be a sad panda. They a lot of folks were predicting on Christmas that we were getting a preview of Big Game 58 against the Niners and the Ravens. You think that could come to fruition?
I mean, the Ravens look very good. Don't get me wrong. The Ravens are looking very good. But like I said, because Kelce Mahomes, or the Mahomes Mahauto, if you follow Jake from State Farm commercials, you'll get that reference. It even though they're shitting the bed a little bit, it's just from history, it's hard to bet against them. But I would be definitely happy for Ravens going, because it's something different. But yeah, fingers crossed.
There you go. Mike Fish, where can people find Claret and Big Blue?
So you can find that on the artist formerly known as Twitter at CBBPod. We'll give you a heads up. It's our recording schedule is a little bit sporadic lately just because of my new working schedule plus Alex, my co-host, has been incredibly selfish and impregnated his wife.
Yep.
So he's having to do things, you know, so that's good. So we've been like doing like an episode every other couple of weeks or every three. So we're hoping in a new year, 2024, we'll be going back to our regular schedule. But so I do apologize if it's not regular as it was. But typically, new episodes will be available around 7 p.m. Eastern on every Tuesday.
There you go. And then, as you heard at the top of the show, it's the Waffle Box Podcast. It's the original Waffle Box. You accept no substitutions. It is the best part of Wednesdays. It's the People's Podcast, coming all the way from the future home of Super Bowl 60. You love us because we do this. We do this because we love you. Hey, for Mike Fish, I've been Kush Hayes. You've been you.
Microdose, yeah, microdose.
From the BozNet family.
I'm banned from Tokyo for 3 years.